Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to social science class. See students, today onwards we will start once again online class. Students, today in this class we are going to learn history pertaining a new lesson, that is integration of Karnataka and border dispute. Today topic is integration. Integration of Karnataka and border disputes. Border disputes. In this lesson, first we will discuss introduction about this lesson. Karnataka is our state. In this introduction, Karnataka, our state, has history 2000 years. Karnataka has history 2000 years. And also, the Kannadigas were lived in the various political system. The Kannadigas were lived in the various political system. After the Vijayanagara, so many Kannada dynasties and also Muslims dynasties were ruled the Kannada. Which are the dynasties are ruled the Kannada state after the falling of Vijayanagara Empire? Means Marathas, Peshwas and different Padegaras, Delhi Sultans and also finally the British were ruled the Kannadigas in nearly 2000 years. As a result, the Kannadigas were experienced to alienation to the Kannadigas in a unity. This is the introduction about this lesson. Understood, children? See, Karnataka state has a 2000 years history. Kannadigas were lived in various political system. Vijayanagara Empire fall after the Kannadigas were ruled by so many Kannada dynasties and also so many Muslim dynasties were ruled the Kannadigas. Which of the dynasties were ruled the Kannadigas? For example, Marathas, Peshwas and different Padegaras and also the Sultans and Delhi Sultans and also the British were ruled the Kannadigas. As a result, the Kannadigas has experienced to the alienation of Kannadigas to become a unity of Kannadigas. This is the introduction about this lesson. Now we will move on the topic. Historical background. Historical background of integration of Karnataka. See students, first historical background of integration of Karnataka. We already know that one. Karnataka state extend from the river Kaveri, to the river Godavari. Totally. This information we get from one very very important, the book is Kaviraja Marga. Kaviraja Marga. In this book, this is very very famous book. This book was written by Amoghavarsha Dhrupadunga. Rashtrakuta dynasty, the famous king Amoghavarsha Dhrupadunga. Amoghavarsha Dhrupadunga was written by Kaviraja Marga. In this books, we know about our Karnataka. Karnataka state extends from the river Kaveri to the river Godavari. After this, the Kannadigas were ruled the more than 20 administrative system. After the Kannadigas, they were ruled by or ruled by the various nearly 20 administrative system. Finally, the Kannadigas were experienced to alienation of the Kannadigas. Alienation of the Kannadigas. See? Alienation of Kannadigas. Understood? After the 20 administrative system, after the Kannadigas were experienced to elimination of Kannadigas in one unity. And what is the meaning of integration of Karnataka? First we learn what is the meaning of integration of Karnataka. Okay? First meaning of integration of Karnataka. Very important 2 marks question. Meaning of Karnataka integration. Meaning of Karnataka. Karnataka integration. Kannadigas fought for all to united under one state. Under one state and one administration. And one administration. One administration. See, Kannadigas, what is the meaning of integration of Karnataka or Karnataka integration? We say in Kannada, Karnataka Ekikarna. Understood? What is the meaning of Karnataka integration? Kannadigas for all to unite under the one state and one administration. This movement is called, is called as integration of Karnataka. Understand, children? What is the meaning of integration of Karnataka? See, the early steps for integration, the early steps of Karnataka integration were put forward by the Bombay regions. It means what? The Karnataka integration first started in the Bombay region. The Karnataka Vidyavardhaka Sangha. very, very important. Vidyavardhaka Sangha was established in the year 1890. Very important this year, you should remember. Karnataka Vidyavardhaka Sangha was established in the year 1890. See, under the chairmanship of R.H. Deshpande. The Kannada Sahitya Parishad was established in 1915 in Bengaluru. When it was established means in Bengaluru. Understood? Kannada Sahitya Parishad was established in the year 1915. Where is in the Bengaluru? See, and it aimed. What was the aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad? It was aimed the facilitating the progress of Kannada language and literature. What is the aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad? What is the aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad? Aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad. See, very important to facilitating the progress of Karnataka. Progress of Kannada language and Kannada literature. Kannada language and Kannada literature. This is the aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad. What is the Kannada Sahitya Parishad? Means to facilitating the progress of Kannada language and Kannada literature. This is the aim of Kannada Sahitya Parishad. See, and also the aiding the integration of Kannada speaking regions, Kannada Ekikarana Sabha. It means what? Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha was started in the Dharwad in 1916. These organizations continued the struggle for integration. Struggle of integration. See students, after the Kannada Sahitya Parishad, Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha. Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha was established in Dharwad. In the year 1916. Understood children? After the Kannada Sahitya Parishad, Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha was established in Dharwad in the year 1916. This gave the more importance to the integration of Karnataka. This Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha is give the more importance to the integration of Karnataka. See, after this, the National Convention of Indian National Congress, after this Karnataka Ekikarana Sabha, after Karnataka National Convention National Convention of Indian Indian National Congress. Indian National Congress. See, Indian National Congress Convention at Belagavi. In the year 1924, National Convention of Indian National Congress at Belagavi in the year 1924. Navanaravina Rao. He formally initiated the progress of Karnataka integration process by the sinking Udayavagali Namma Cheluva Kannada Nadu. See, Udayavagali. Udayavagali Namma Cheluva Kannada Nadu. This is the poem. What is this? This is one of the famous poem. Udayavagali Namma Cheluva Udayavagali Namma Cheluva Kannada Nadu. This poem was written by Uyyagula Narayana Rao. Very important. One last question. See, when he wrote the poem Udayavagali Namma Cheluva Kannada Nadu, see, this is a welcome song in Kannada. This is the welcome song in Kannada. Gandhiji, who was the president of convention? It means what? The Indian National Congress and one national convention at Belagavi in 1924. Who is the president of National Congress convention at Belagavi? Means the president, that the Congress president is Mahatma Gandhiji, and extended the, his support to the integration movement. Gandhiji also gave the more support to the integration of Karnataka in the year 1924. The integration movement worked in the favor of the freedom movement. The integration of Karnataka movement worked the favor of freedom struggle in India. Understood, children? Next. The role of newspaper, literature and integration movement. What are the role of newspaper and literature in the movement of Karnataka integration? In next class, we will discuss role of the newspaper and literature in the integration of Karnataka. Understood, children? Okay, thank you.